Okay, right here, these are three angles of a triangle. So I'm going to say 5x minus 60 plus z plus y is equal to 180 by the triangle sum theorem. I'm also going to say linear pair right here. So I'm going to say 5x plus z is equal to 180. And then I'm also going to say base angles of an isosceles triangle are equal. So I'm going to say 5x minus 60 is equal to z. Now, watch what I do here. Before I go on, is there anybody who doesn't understand how I got any one of these three equations? Again.
Why do you have to add those three?
Well, honestly, at this point, I'm just brainstorming. I'm writing down everything I see.
I don't
think all right, watch again. Look up at the screen. The three angles of a triangle add up to 180. You understand that one?
Mm-hmm.
Linear pair right next to each other. This one plus this one adds up to 180. And then base angles are equal. This one is equal to this one because it's an isosceles triangle. So now I got my three formulas. Is everybody clear on that? Next. This one right here has three variables. I don't want that one. This one's got an x and a y, x and a z rather, and this one's got an x and a z. So I'm going to take all of this, which is z, and substitute in place of that z right there. Now you were taught algebra 1, and you were taught the substitution property, and I think I tried to teach it to you as well. So I get 5x plus my substitute is equal to 180. And this is the substitution property. So now I simplify. I get 10x. Try to memorize what I'm doing here. I'm going to add and get 240. And then I'm going to divide by 10 and get 24. It's by the division property on this one. So I get x is 24. So again, notice what I did. At first, I wasn't sure, and just like you may not be, so you write down your formulas. All three add up to 180, these two add up to 180, and these two are equal. Didn't want the top one because it has three variables. I substituted all of this in place of the z. I combined like terms, worked it out, and got 24. Any questions on this problem? All right, memorize it. Next. This one right here, the whole segment AC is equal to 24, so you should have equal 24. Some kids are saying it equals 180. This is not an angle. By the segment addition postulate, I'm going to say it again, segment addition postulate, you might want to write that down, these two segments add up to the whole thing. I simplify and get 5x. I subtract and get 15, and then I divide by the division property and get 3. So on your test, if they want to know x, you're finished. If they want to know this piece, you would say 3 times 3. If you want to know this piece, 2 times 3 is 6 plus 9 is 15. If you add that up, you do get 24. Any questions on how to do the 5-minute check for today? All right, next. Put your 5-minute check away and try this one, please. Draw the triangle and try that problem. Now, those of you that were caught in between, Julia, Kirsten, and Natalie, I'm going to reset it. And then therefore it should show up. In fact, it looks like I already did reset it. So when you log back in tonight, you're going to see the test again. So go through it properly. Don't rush through it. I mean, I heard what she said, and I know what you're going to tell me, but it's not showing as completed. So you want to make sure, okay? And while you guys are working on that one, let me look up this one student and see if we can figure this one out. right, Kaylee, I'm in. And what was the problem? Did you put the S period on there?
Yeah.
That's the problem. See, look, come see. Let me just make sure you see it. If you just look at my screen, you'll see your name, and then you see the OLA. Leave this off here, and then you can get in.
Thank you.
You're welcome. What you should recognize, and this is what you're always looking for, you're looking for vertical angles, you're looking for linear pairs, the triangle sum theorem, exterior angle theorem. In this case, we're dealing with what? Does anybody know what theorem we're going to use? Nobody in here knows what theorem we're going to use? It's called the mid-segment theorem. Write it down. The mid-segment theorem says that two of these is equal to one of these. So two of these is equal to the base. Any questions on this mid-segment theorem? Again, two of these equal one of these. How do I know this is a mid-segment? It shows up as congruent. So this is a midpoint. Good. And this is a midpoint. And therefore, it's called a mid-segment. They're actually parallel as well. All right, work this problem out if you didn't already do so. Distribute and try to solve it. All right, any questions on how I got 9? Now on the test, if they ask for X, you're finished. But if they want the mid-segment, then you got to go 3 times 9 plus 5. It's not a hard problem, so memorize it. And remember the reason. On the test, if they do this, you're going to say mid-segment theorem. All right, next. Draw this diagram and see if you can figure out how to find those. Draw that diagram and see if you can figure out how to find those. Even if you put something else like 20, this is just practice. The main thing is you understand the concept. All right, let me call on some people and see if they can kind of help me out. Some of you are still working, so I'll wait about another minute. All right, Jacob, tell me what to do, sir. What? Whichever one you want to do, I don't care. $30 and $90. All right, so between the two of these, I think that's $120. And when I subtract it from 180, what do I get here? All right, so this is 60 degrees. Jacob, if this is 60 degrees, what is this and why? Why? They're straight across from each other. Anybody know what that's called? They're vertical. So if this is 60, this is 60. How would I get this next one right here? Rachel, how would I get X if I know this is 60 and this is 60? Okay. What I would do here is, if I know this is 60, I would say that these two right here make a linear pair. So I would say 60 plus X equals 180.
Okay, so then X would be 120.
Exactly. So if X is 120, Aaliyah, what is Z? Y. Because they're vertical. Kaylee, if this is 60 and this is 70, how do I find P? Add 60 plus 60 plus 70 and subtract it from 180. All right, I had a couple more, but I want to give you enough time to do your classwork. Friday, I checked the workbook work. Today, you got 12 problems here, and then your homework is worksheet number 4. I don't think I checked number 3 yet, but number 4 is tonight, and I may check number 3 tomorrow. So copy down your assignment, and I'll work with you in a moment. Now, some of you, if you don't get it down, you just have to ask your neighbor. This is the book. What did you miss? The video should be online. I would just watch the video. Oh, yeah. Workbook, page 75. I think it was 1 through 20. Last 5 minutes, you can always grab my CD card and see. Remember, draw the diagram. If you don't have the diagrams, I'm not going to give you credit. All right? I want to see the diagrams and I want to see some work. Remember, part A for the next test, if you do better on it and you come see me, maybe I can swap out the grades for that first test. I put the answers online if you need to look at them. All right, does anybody need help on number one or number two? Be honest, okay? Yes, ma'am. All right, take a look at one. The very first thing you should notice is it's an isosceles. And one of the properties you need to say to yourself is base angles are equal. So this is 70. Don't miss that, okay? Base angles are equal. I have 2A up here as well. Same concept. Are anybody stuck? Jacqueline, you need help?
No.
Yes, ma'am? 2B? All right, look up. First thing I notice is it's an isosceles. That 42 I would put over here as well. Now they're looking for X, so you have 42. One of the properties, I don't know that I talked about, but I'm going to tell you in just a second. Thank you, sir. Oh, here you go. He didn't show up. Check in the clinic or somewhere. All right, so look up here. One of the properties that I didn't tell you, I'm going to tell you now. If you have an isosceles triangle and the vertex angle is bisected, that means cut in half, then you have 90 degrees down here. So right away, you should recognize 90 degrees on both of those. And you know that this one is 42. So I would subtract 90 and 42 to get X. Try to memorize that property. Bless you. All right, I'm going to walk around, so if you need help, just stop me.
Isosceles prime bisection. Therefore, these are 90. You got to know that. And if this is 90, this one's 42, and so is that one. So you subtract 42 and 90 from 180, and you get that. You got to know that property that I'm telling you. If it's a bisector of an isosceles, then it hits at 90. First thing I would do, let me put this one up here. I'm going to do number 11 on 270.
So if you need it, you might want to take a look. 270. All right, look up here. This is what I would do. First of all, I would put a Y right here. And then you have a linear pair. So I would move my Y right here. And then this is a linear pair. So Y has to be 70 because it's got to add up to 180. So if Y is 70, you subtract both of these and you get that one. That top angle is called the vertex angle. You might want to write that down. The vertex angle is like the eye on the pyramid on your dollar bill. It's the top angle of an isosceles triangle. Don't be afraid to move things around. Yep. The proof. Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
All right, look right here. See how it says segment KM bisects the bottom?
Mm-hmm.
All right, look. And I always look at given. And here it is right here. Bisects. Right here should be KM segment. So I would put given there, but make sure you understand that it's given. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
All right, look at the next one. Why is this piece equal to this piece? Why is this piece equal to this piece? This is a bisector. If it bisects it, it cuts it in half. So I would say definition of segment bisector. Definition of segment bisector. I mean, it said it bisects it. So the next one is definition. You with me? All right. They gave us that it's an isosceles triangle. This is equal to this, given. Read the next one, please. All right, read it properly. What is this? Is it a line? Is it an angle? What is it? Segment KM. Keep going.
Segment KM
is congruent.
Congruent to
itself. What property a long time ago, like looking in the mirror, something equal to itself. Anybody remember that one? Something equal to itself. What? Reflexive. Very good. Reflexive property. That was a long time ago. But there it is. All right, now read it. Triangle. All right, look. we have this side equal to itself. We have this piece equal to this piece by definition of segment bisector. This is something that I didn't talk about, but I'm going to tell you. It's called side, side, side. The triangles are congruent by side, side, side. You remember that? Where do you remember that from? Okay, side, 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 which I never did tell you, but there it is. And now the pieces are congruent by this reason. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Once you prove that the triangles are congruent, you can say their parts are congruent. So those are two new concepts. I don't know that you're going to see that on this test. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are congruent. Corresponding parts. And rather than write it all out, they use that notation. or who needs help. Yeah.
On page 193,
number
26.
Okay. See right here? Did you read all of this?
Uh-huh.
All right, it's a triangle. These are the angles. So what you're going to do is use the triangle sum theorem. So x plus 2x plus 3x equals 180. And then combine all of that. That's 3, 2 plus 1, 3 and 3 is 6. And then divide 6 and 18 goes 3 times. So x equals 30. So one angle is 30 degrees. 2 times 30 is 60. And 3 times 30 is 90. It's a 30, 60, 90 triangle. That's a special one. And we'll be talking about that one later in the year. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Triangle sum theorem.
Yeah.